all to my video class. Today I will discuss about the chapter current electricity. So let me tell you the basic difference between electrostatic and current electricity, that is also called electrodynamics. Okay, right? So see, actually electrostatic deals with study of charges and rest, because its name is electrostatic, and you know static means rest, right? But current electricity actually this deals with charges in motion. This is the basic difference. In electrostatic, that deals with study of charges at rest, but current electricity or electrodynamic that deals with charges in motion, right? So now actually I will start from electric current. So let me define what is electric current. Right? You understand? ବର୍ତ୍ତମାନ ତମେ ଏଇ ଯେଉଁ ଦେଖୁଛ ମୋତେ ମୋର ଭଏସ୍ ଶୁଣୁଛ ଏଇଟା ଯେଉଁ କରେଣ୍ଟ କ'ଣ ପାଇଁ ତମେ ଭାବୁଥିବ କ'ଣ ସାର୍ଙ୍କ ଦେଖିପାରୁ ଯେଉଁ ଭଏସ୍ ଶୁଣୁଛୁ କେମିତି କରେଣ୍ଟ ଯେଉଁ ହେଉଛି କରେଣ୍ଟ ଯେଉଁ ମୋବାଇଲ ଅଛି ତମର ଚାର୍ଜ କରୁଛୁ କ'ଣ ନାହିଁ ଆଉ ମୁଁ ବି ଏଇଟା କରିକି ତମକୁ ପଠେଇ ପାରିଲି ଗାଡ଼ି ଯାଉଛୁ ଯେଉଁ କରେଣ୍ଟ ତମେ ଘରେ ଅଛ ଏସି ଲଗେଇଛ ମୁଁ ଏଠି ଏସି ଲଗେଇକି ବସିକି ରେକର୍ଡିଂ କରୁଛି ସବୁ କରେଣ୍ଟ ଯେଉଁ ପସିବୁଲ୍ ହେଇପାରୁଛି ତମେ ଘରେ ଟ୍ୟାପ୍ ବୋଲେ ପାଣି ଭାବୁଛି କେଉଁଟା ଅଛି ପାଣି ମନ ମନ ପଳେଇ ଆସୁଛି କେଉଁଟା ଅଛି ପାଣି କେଉଁଟା ହେଉଛି ନା ପୁଣି ସେ କରେଣ୍ଟ ଯୋଗୁଁ ମଟର ଚଲାଉଛ ପାଣି ପାଣି ଉଠାଉଛି ଯୋଉଠୁ କରେଣ୍ଟ ସୋ ଆମେ କରେଣ୍ଟ ଯୋଗୁଁ ସବୁ କାମ ମ୍ୟାକ୍ସିମମ୍ କାମ ଆଜିକାଲି ସହଜରେ କରିପାରୁଛୁ ତା ମାନେ ଯେ ବିନା କରେଣ୍ଟରେ ହେଇପାରିବନି ବଟ୍ ଇଜିଲି ଆମେ କରିପାରୁଛୁ ଓକେ ସୋ ଏତେ ସବୁ କାମ କରେଣ୍ଟ କରୁଛି ସେ କରେଣ୍ଟ ବିଷୟରେ ଆମେ ବର୍ତ୍ତମାନ ଟିକେ ଜ୍ଞାନ ପାଇବା ଟିକେ ତା ବିଷୟରେ ଜାଣିବା ଓକେ ସୋ ଫାଷ୍ଟ ଆଇ ୱିଲ୍ ଟେଲ୍ ୟୁ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଇଲେକ୍ଟ୍ରିକ୍ Let me explain about that. What I have written here, the rate of flow of charge across any cross section of a conductor. The rate of flow of charge across any cross section of a conductor, that means what? The amount of charge flowing divided by time, or also you can write like this, the amount of charge flowing Then average current, if I am taking now del Q del V, see, actually I am telling now del Q amount of charge is flowing through a conductor in a time del T, then the average current, I average is equal to del Q divided by del T. You can write simply Q by T, I have written del Q by del T, if you have all simply the point of Q amount of charge of T time, the average current is equal to Q by T. ଯଦି ଗୋଟେ କଣ୍ଡକ୍ଟରର ଗୋଟେ କ୍ରସ୍ ସେକ୍ସନରେ କ୍ୟୁ ଆମାଉଣ୍ଟର ଚାର୍ଜ ଟି ଟାଇମରେ ଯାଉଛି ତାହେଲେ ଆଭରେଜ୍ କରେଣ୍ଟ କେତେ ହେଲା ନା ଚାର୍ଜ ବାଇ ଟାଇମ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ସ କଲ୍ ରେଟ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଫ୍ଲୋ ଅଫ୍ ଚାର୍ଜ ଅର୍ ଆମାଉଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଚାର୍ଜ ଫ୍ଲୋଇଂ ଫର୍ ୟୁନିଟ୍ ଟାଇମ୍ ଏକ୍ରସ୍ ଏନି କ୍ରସ୍ ସେକ୍ସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏ କଣ୍ଡକ୍ଟର ଶୁଣ ତ କରେଣ୍ଟ ସବୁଥିରେ ଫ୍ଲୋ କରିବନି କରେଣ୍ଟ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଓନ୍ଲି ଫ୍ଲୋ ଥ୍ରୁ କଣ୍ଡକ୍ଟର କରେଣ୍ଟ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଏଭର୍ ପାସ୍ ଥ୍ରୁ ଇନ୍ସୁଲେଟର ତମେ ଜାଣିଛୁ ତ ଆମେ କରେଣ୍ଟର ଡେଫିନେସନ୍ ତମ ପାଇଁ ଗୋଟେ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ କଥା ମନେ ରଖ କରେଣ୍ଟ ଆକ୍ଚୁଲି ତମେ ବି ଜାଣିଛ Current is a physical quantity which has both magnitude and direction, but still it is a scalar quantity. Why? It is a scalar quantity. It has magnitude and direction, okay? It is called a scalar quantity because it doesn't obey the law of vector addition, right? So, electric current is a scalar quantity. Remember, it has magnitude and direction, but it is a scalar quantity because it doesn't obey the law of vector addition, okay? So, let me tell you about unit of current. Unit of current. The unit of current is ampere. Okay, you can write capital A. Okay, capital A for ampere. In SI system, actually we always use this system, SI system to write the unit of current, ampere. Other units are also there in CGA system, start ampere also. So you remember this unit, SI unit of current is ampere. Okay, so now actually this current here, see, I have written this average current. Average current means there is total charge by total time, right? But instantaneous current, instantaneous current. Actually, instantaneous current is equal to limit, I'm writing del t tends to 0, del q by del t, this is equal to dq by dt. Just remember, this type of formula, so many times I have written in master, instantaneous current equal to limit del t tends to 0, del q by del t, this is equal to dq by dt. So, you dq by dt, you can put it in the derivative of q for charge with respect to time. So, instantaneous current means that the current at a particular instant or at a particular time. Which is, you can know the current is called. How long will you know current is a scalar quantity will have done it? Then, हमें तारो यूनिट जाने आउ तारो एवरेज करेंट का फार्मूला पाइले आउ रे इंस्टेंटेनियस करेंट का फार्मूला पाइले तो वेबे कहतली करेंट इज अ फिजिकल क्वांटिटी व्हिच हैज बोथ मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन सो हम बर्तमान लिखे करेंट का डायरेक्शन केम थे जा ओके सी है दिस इज अ कंडक्टर है दिस इज अ कंडक्टर एंड यू नो इन अ कंडक्टर देयर आर लार्ज नंबर ऑफ फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स राइट सो दिस वन एक्चुअली वी आर नाउ गिविंग potential difference, you know actually current can only flow whenever there is a potential difference between the two ends. So potential difference is there, but the battery level is there, this V. So potential difference, I have to manage of electrons are negative in charge particle, these electrons move from this region, that means electrons move towards the positive terminal, but the direction of the current, this is actually the direction of the current. This is the very important part for you, always you remember one more point out of the way. Current or direction that's over in here, electron or motion that two direction away, that opposite it, the region gone, and that's a whole. Electron flow motion is important, but current or direction down to that opposite it. Karana, the government is anicho, it's simple what I'm going to do. So, anicho, heat always flows from high temperature to low temperature. Heat always flows from high temperature to low temperature. So, similarly, you know, gas always flows from high pressure to low pressure. Right? Water flows always from high level to low level. So, here current flows or the direction of current is from high potential to low potential, right? But electron flows from low potential to high potential. Direction of current is always, this is also called, remember, conventional. This is the direction of pump electron, this is the direction of conventional current. Okay. So the direction of current always remember always that is from high potential to low potential or that is always in the opposite direction of the flow of electron. So the circuit diagram for the direction of electron flow for the opposite is the current direction of the. So students remember this is also a very important thing. So many times you will not confuse about that, about the direction of current. Okay, direction of current is always opposite to the direction of flow of electron. So, see, actually till now I have told you what is electric current, its definition, instantaneous current, average current, basing upon all these concepts, we can solve some numericals. First question I am going to do.